Hello YouTube, how's it going? Do you wish to rejuvenate your home's look? Do you wish to create an eye-catching feature wall? Do you wish to have voice-controlled smart lights installed on your wall? Are you on a limited budget but still want to get that feature wall? Fear not, as I have all the above concerns covered in today's DIY video. Today, we will be installing a feature wall consisting of timber wood slats and voice-controlled smart LED lights. This project involves power tools with sharp blades and heavy wood, so do ensure that you have all the necessary protective gear before starting the project. So, what are you waiting for? Let's begin! We start off the project by clearing or taking off any pictures or decorations previously installed on the wall. Then, we go on to remove any nails or screws on the wall. Once the screws have been removed, it is important to fill the holes and blemishes on the wall with a wall filler or a putty. This will ensure that the wall has a perfect and smooth finish. Now, it's time to mask the walls. Ensure that you mask all the edges and places you don't want your paint to show, especially the ceiling and skirting. To paint the background wall, I have chosen black, which contrasts well with the brown of the timber wood. You can choose any color that suits your taste and design. Painting can be messy, so ensure that your floor is covered up with dust cloth or plastic sheets to avoid overspills. To paint the edges, use a smaller roller or a brush. Painting can be significantly quicker if you have a paint spray gun. With all the painting done, it's time to find the studs. It's important that the timber support slat is screwed to the studs or else the structure may fall due to the lack of stability. Drill the holes into the support slat based on where you find the studs. A rule of thumb is that the distance between each stud is approximately 16 or 24 inches. In my case, it was 24 inches. Now mount the support onto the wall, aligning the drilled holes to the stud marking on the wall, and screw them in place to secure them. While installing the support slat, do ensure that it is in level to the ground by using a spirit level. For the wall slats, I have used a 2x2 plane timber which is 2.4 meter long. A plane timber is a finished product with smooth edges so that we don't have to deal with any further refining or sanding during our project. Based on the design template that I have shared in the description, mark down all your timber wood where you want to cut the wood. For cutting the wood, I'm using a miter saw. A miter saw allows you to adjust the angle and the depth of the cut to get a perfect finish. An important thing to consider while cutting the wood is that one also needs to take into account the width of the blade. As when we cut the wood, we tend to lose some wood as sawdust, which is equivalent to the width of the blade. Also, ensure that you use a saw blade with at least 80 teeth, as this gives you a much cleaner cut.
all the wood slats cut, now it's time to cut out the hole to install the LED lights. Mark the center and use a spade wood drill bit to cut the holes. The drill bit needs to be wider than the LED bulbs so that it can easily slip inside. Remember, as per the design, the lights are installed only into every alternate wood slide. We also need to drill a hole on the back to route the wires from the bulb. Now it's time to arrange the slats as per the design in the template. It would be great if you have a workspace or a garage to do this work, or else you will end up messing the kitchen as I have done in my case. I'm grouping up the slats in a set of 5 as this helps in easy installation onto the wall and wiring up. To glue the set together, use a good quality wood glue like Gorilla Wood Glue. Align up the slats and hold them together using a ratchet strap. After gluing, it is important to hold them together as this strengthens the bond of the glue and the slats won't come apart once the glue dries. Give it at least 6 to 8 hours for the glue to completely dry. Once the glue has completely dried, we need to cut out grooves on the set. These grooves will help us to install the slats onto the timbered support structure installed on the walls. The groove needs to match the width of the support timber slat. I'm also making grooves to route the wires as well. Complete, it should look something like this. For the lights, I'm using a 1.2 watt G4 LED bulb. Because I need about 40 bulbs for my wall, I chose a low lumen bulb. You can go with a higher lumen bulb if you require fewer bulbs for your project. We also require a G4 bulb holder to connect the bulb. For wiring, I'm using a 1mm thick wire which should be sufficient to support the load of the bulbs. Route the wires through the holes that we drilled and connect the wire to the LED bulb holder. I'm using heat shrink tubes to secure the wire joints and shrinking them using a heat gun. With all the bulbs wired, it's now time to connect the wires to the main line. Understand the main circuit, use the image shown on the screen now. I've also attached this image into the description if you want to look at it later. Because we are building a set of 5 wood slats, we need to leave the input and output connection wire so that we can easily attach them to the subsequent sets later. Now it's time to attach the set to the wall. Place the set onto the timber support slat on the wall and then connect the wires to the previously installed slat and use the heat shrink tube to secure the connection. Slide the slats to align with the previous set and then drill holes on the wood where you intend to screw. Drilling before screwing is a good practice as it prevents any splits on the timber or cracking. Before screwing, make a countersink hole using a countersink bit. This is done so that the screw head sinks into the wood and does not protrude outside. Finally, secure the wooden slats by screwing into the timber support. I am also screwing into the bottom of the slats to secure them in place. Ensure to test the lights after installing each set to determine any wiring failure, as it will be easy to diagnose. Once all the slats are installed, it will be painful to determine any failure points. After all the slats are installed, I'm covering up the holes with a good quality wood filler. I'm using natural wood colored filler. Leave up to 5 hours for the filler to dry and then sand them to remove any excess and create a smooth finish. because my design has alternate wooden slats in different shades. I am masking alternate slats so that I can only apply colored varnish to the desired slats. I chose to go with walnut brown finish for the project. You can choose colors that suit your taste or even go with paint. I wanted to highlight the grain on the wood and hence chose varnish. Apply up to 4 coats of varnish to achieve the final desired finish. Once the varnish dries up, take off all the masking tapes. As a final finishing touch, I'm also applying a clear coat varnish on all the sets. To enable voice-activated control over the lights, I'm using a smart Wi-Fi plug from TP-Link. We also require a 12-volt and 60-watt AC to DC adapter to power up the LED lights. Now, because I have a huge radiator on my wall, I also have to make a radiator cover that blends in with the wall slats. This step is optional. For the radiator cover, I am making L joints. This involves cutting the blocks at 45 degrees and then joining them together. I am only connecting the alternate slats as the gaps serve as ventilation for the radiator to emit heat when functioning. To make a L joint, first glue down the two pieces cut at 45 degrees and then screw in a metal L joint to secure the joint. Finally, drill holes onto the base slat to install the L joints too. This will add rigidity to the L joints and also act as the base support. This is how the finished radiator cover looks like.
After hours of toiling hard, I'm really happy with the end product. Let's have a look.
Alexa, turn on kitchen lights.
So guys, what did you think? I hope you enjoyed watching the video as much as I enjoyed making it. I hope the video inspires few of you to do something similar or even replicating this project. It requires some effort from your side, but it's economical and the end result is pleasing. I've used minimal amount of power tools that can be easily sourced at your local hardware stores. I've also added the link to all the tools and materials used in the description below. If you have any queries, please feel free to ask in the comment section below, or if you have any suggestion that I can use in future projects, I'm all ears. If you like the video, please hit the like button and kindly support our channel by subscribing and sharing.